In this lecture, we'll discuss more about the Reynolds number. Which is defined as the density times the characteristic speed times the characteristic length of the system in which fluid flow is taking place over the dynamic viscosity. It can also be written as the characteristic speed u times the length scale over the kinematic viscosity, and kinematic viscosity is defined as the dynamic viscosity over the density of the fluid. So we have seen that the Reynolds number appears in the non-dimensionalized governing equations for fluid flow. So to recall these non-dimensionalized governing equations, we first have the continuity equation for incompressible flow, which simply says that del dot u is zero and everything is in dimensionless terms, and the Navier-Stokes equations where the Reynolds number actually appears. Now if you recall that to derive this equation, we had used a scaling for pressure which was P. The characteristic scale for pressure scales as mu u by L. And this scale we obtained by balancing the pressure gradient and the viscous term. But in certain cases, particularly for high speed flows, where the inertia actually dominates, the proper scale for pressure is obtained by balancing the pressure gradient with the inertial term, which is the nonlinear term, and from this balance we obtain the scale for pressure, which is capital P over here, as this, and that means pressure scales as rho times u squared. Now if you use this pressure scale and the characteristic scale for pressure instead of this one over here, you will get non-dimensionalized Navier-Stokes equations, but instead of this equation over here, which is valid for, which is scale for low speed, which is non-dimensionalized for low speed flows, instead we will get, in this case, if we use this scale for pressure, we'll get the non-dimensionalized momentum equation as this. So in this case, these equations are usually this scaling is used for high speed flows, and we are not going to use this form of the Navier-Stokes equations. But the point of telling you about this equation is that, you know, irrespective of how we scale the pressure, in both these cases, in this case and in this case, we see that the incompressible flow is that is characterized by one length scale u and a time scale l by u is controlled by a single dimensionless number, and that is the Reynolds number. So that is the Reynolds number. So the fluid flow can be simply described if we know the value of the Reynolds number. Now if you recall that I mentioned that for transport phenomena, often it is helpful to look at the dimensionless numbers as ratio of two time scales. So we have Reynolds number, which is given as rho u l over mu or u l over nu, and we can think of the Reynolds number, which is dimensionless, in terms of the ratio of two time scales. And to see that, we can write this form of Reynolds number as u over l and times l squared over nu. Now, nu is actually the kinematic viscosity, and it has same units as diffusivity. That is, the units are meter squared per second. So kinematic viscosity tells us how fast, or kinematic viscosity tells us the rate at which the momentum actually diffuses. So so you can call nu, which is the kinematic viscosity, as so that means that, for example, I have a plate over which we have some fluid, and if I suddenly start moving this plate, then kinematic viscosity governs that after how much time, you know, the information or the momentum that has been imparted by this plate to the adjoining layer of fluid actually diffuses into the adjoining layer, okay, or diffuses into the fluid. So typically what we have is that if you have you are stationed at some distance L from this plate, and you suddenly start moving this plate, so the time scale over which the momentum would diffuse, which I'll call as again the diffusive time scale, and here the diffusion is of the momentum, so the diffusive time scale is given as L squared over nu. And this is same similar to the diffusive time scale for diffusion of a solute, as we saw in the T sensor in one of the earlier lectures. Now we can see that this term over here is the diffusive time scale, whereas the term over here is the time scale for convection. Now therefore we can think of the Reynolds number as the ratio of two time scales, that is the diffusive time scale over the convective time scale. And here I meant that the convective time scale is given by L over U. So if you think in terms of the time scales, so Reynolds number is the ratio of diffusive time scale over the convective time scale, it is more intuitive to describe what happens at low and high values of Reynolds number. So first we look at the case when the diffusive time scale, that is L squared over nu, is much, much less than the convective time scale L over u. In that case, the Reynolds number is much, much less than 1. Okay, so when the time scale for momentum diffusion is really small, that means that is the case when the viscous effects are actually dominant than the inertia. So when viscous effects are dominant, as we have in microfluidic systems, then we have low Reynolds number, and that was the reason we took the limit of Reynolds number to 0 in the Navier-Stokes equations, and we got the simplified Stokes equation, and that was in dimensionless variables we had gradient of P is balanced by the viscous forces, and in dimensional form this equation is gradient of P is equal to mu times del squared U. So this is the dimensionless form and this is the dimensional form of the Stokes equation. Now in the opposite case, that is when the inertia dominates, in that case the convective time scale is much smaller than the diffusive time scale L squared over nu, and therefore we have Reynolds number which is much larger than 1. For microfluidic systems, usually the speed, the flow speed, is order a few millimeters or less. So let's take the flow speed to be 10 to power minus 3 meters per second, and the length scale is of the order 100 micrometers, and that is 10 to power minus 4 meters. And the kinematic viscosity for water is 10 to power minus 6 meters per meter squared per second. So if we use these values to compute the Reynolds number, we have 10 to power minus 3 times 10 to power minus 4 over 10 to power minus 6, and that is 0.1. So even if we look at the upper limit of the flow speed in microfluidic devices, even then the Reynolds number H is at least one order less than 1. So for microfluidic systems it is sufficient to use the Stokes equation. Now one thing to note, an important thing to note, is that when we actually derived the Stokes equation for low Reynolds number flows, we assumed that the characteristic time scale of the flow is the intrinsic convective time scale, which is given as L over U. Now this is not always the case, because let's consider this system where we have flow between two walls, and one of the wall is fixed, and this wall is fixed, whereas the top wall is, let's say, oscillating with some frequency which has units of hertz. Now in this case the time scale, the proper time scale, okay, depends upon the frequency. So the proper way of non-dimensionalizing time for such a system where you have an oscillating wall, or you may have oscillating pressure, you should choose the dimensionless time as T times F. So F has units of hertz or 1 over second, so multiplying F with T, that is dimensional time, you get a non-dimensionalized time. Now if we use this time instead of L over U to non-dimensionalize the Navier-Stokes equations, we get a different equation, different form of non-dimensional Navier-Stokes equation. So let's do that. So let's again look at the dimensional form of Navier-Stokes equations, and we can quickly write that. So we are using dimensional variables. So we have the non-linear term next, pressure gradient, and the viscous term. So this is the dimensional form of Navier-Stokes equation. Now if we use this time scale, and the velocity scale is u, so dimensionless u is given by u over the characteristic speed of the flow, okay, and again we use the characteristic scale for pressure, which is mu u by L, okay, and all the spatial derivatives in dimensionless form will be L times the derivative in dimensional terms. Then we can write the Navier-Stokes equation in non-dimensional form. As so, first we now use this time scale. So we have density times, so instead of u we are now substituting this value of u over here. So we have capital U, which is constant, and now for time we are using this form of non-dimensionalization. So we have in this case times F, okay, and rest all terms actually remain the same. So we'll have just like what we had in the previous case, where we used the intrinsic time scale L over U, and pressure scales with this scaling. So you have mu U over L squared, and we have minus gradient P plus the viscous term. So now if you simplify this equation, what you're going to get is, on you can bring this term to the left hand side, and if you simplify this equation, you're going to get F times rho over into L squared, and then we have this term. We'll get the Reynolds number just like we had in our previous derivation of non-dimensional Navier-Stokes equations. And here we have the pressure term and the viscous term. Okay, so now you recognize that this term is the Reynolds number. Now let's look at this term over here. So you can think of this term as F rho L squared, and you can multiply and divide by U, and then think of this term as and group it into two separate terms. So first is so there was a mu over here which came from the right hand side, and we have a mu over here, so we have rho L u over mu times F L over u. Okay, so now we can instead of writing the equation in this form, we can actually write our dimensionless governing equation as the Reynolds number times FL by U, and then we have the transient term, then all other terms are same as what we have seen earlier while non-dimensionalizing the Navier-Stokes equation. Now, so all of these terms are actually in dimensionless form, and Reynolds number is a dimensionless number, and this number in the brackets is also a dimensionless number because the speed, the characteristic speed has units of meters per second, and here we have L which has units of meter, and F which is having units of 1 over second. Now this dimensionless number is actually called the Struhal number. Okay, now Struhal number, which is denoted by ST, is given by FL over U. So again, we can look at the Struhal number as the ratio of two time scales. So the first time scale is the time scale L over U, which is the convective time scale, and the other time scale is related to the frequency. So one of the over the frequency is the time scale for the oscillation. So so we can see that if the oscillations are really fast, okay, then the oscillation time scale is much less than the convective time scale, and therefore the Struhal number will be much greater than 1. So this is when you have fast oscillations. On the other hand, if the oscillations are slow, in that case the time scale for oscillations is really large compared with the convective time scale, and the Struhal number is much less than 1. So if you look at this equation over here, where you have the term Reynolds number times the Struhal number, now even if in microfluidic systems you have Reynolds number which is really small, the Struhal number need not be small. So if you have the case where the oscillations are really fast compared with the convective time scale, in such cases Reynolds number times the Struhal number need not be less than much less than 1. In that case, even though we can neglect this nonlinear inertia term, we need to include the transient term. Therefore, the Navier-Stokes equation for oscillating flows where the Struhal number is much larger than 1 and the Reynolds number is much less than 1, but still the Reynolds number times this Struve-Hall number is not negligible. For such cases, the Navier-Stokes equation in dimensionless form can be written as this. We recall that the time scale, the time is actually non-dimensionalized using the frequency, and we don't have the non-linear inertia term, and there's pressure and the viscous term over here. So in dimensional form, actually this equation is same as the Navier-Stokes equation, just that we neglect the inertia term. So in dimensional form, you can write this equation as okay, so this is and we have viscosity over here. So this is the unsteady form of the Stokes equation. Okay, so even though you have this transient term, we have been able to use able to simplify this non-linear Navier-Stokes equation to a linear equation. So even if you have this transient term, you still have the equation which is actually a linear equation, which is much easy to solve compared with the non-linear equation. And this simplification comes from the fact that the Reynolds number H is much less than 1 for microscale flows.